significance of double fertilization and post-fertilization changes. Coming to fertilization. Fertilization in angiosperms is unique and it is called as double fertilization. This is because there are two sperms or male gametes in the pollen tube. One of the male gamete or the sperm fuses with the egg cell that is present in the embryo sac in between the synergids towards the micropylar region, while the remaining male gamete or the sperm fuses with the secondary nucleus, which is formed by fusion of two polar nuclei, and this results in formation of a triploid structure which is known as primary endosperm nucleus. Primary endosperm nucleus is a nutritive tissue for the developing embryo. This triple fusion, that is double fertilization, was first observed by Navaschin in Fritillaria and Lilium. Coming to the significance. The significance of double fertilization is as follows. Two products are obtained as a result of double fertilization, and that is formation of egg, that is a zygote and endosperm. There are chances of polyembryony and the plants has better chances of survival. And double fertilization gives rise to an endosperm that provides nourishment to the developing embryo. It increases the viability of the seeds of angiosperms. And the post-fertilization changes that occur are as follows. That is, after fertilization, several changes take place in the floral part up to the formation of the seed. Thus, events after fertilization, that is endosperm, which is formed by the fusion of the secondary nucleus with the male gamete, embryo, which is formed by fusion of male gamete with the egg cell, then formation of seed and fruit, are the called the post-fertilization changes. Endosperm. Endosperm is a nutritive tissue which is developed from primary endosperm nucleus of the embryo sac. It is a product of triple fusion, that is the fusion of male gamete with the two polar nuclei, that is the secondary nucleus. Therefore, it is known as triple fusion. There are three general types of endosperm formation, namely nuclear type, cellular type and helobial type. Coming to the embryogeny. Embryogeny is defined as a process of growth and development of an embryo from a zygote in the flowering plants. It is developed from egg cell of the embryo sac as a result of syngamy, that is the fusion of male gamete with the female gamete, that is egg, and synergids and the antipodal cells will degenerate. Formation of seeds and fruit. Simultaneously with the development of an embryo and endosperm, the ovary enlarges. Ovary is a part of the pistil. It is present at the basal region. Above this is the style, and uppermost of the tip of this style is the stigmatic region. Now, the non-essential parts of the flower, namely the sepals, petals, and even the stamens, style, stigma fall off, and ovary changes into the fruit. Ovary wall changes into pericarp, that is the fruit wall. The fruit wall is known as a pericarp. Pericarp initially is green. and on ripening becomes orange, red, purple, yellow, etc. Each ovule in the ovary also enlarges. The ovules are present inside the ovary and in the locules, and the number of locules in ovary varies. It may be 1, 2 or many. Each ovule in the ovary enlarges. Outer integument, inner integument become thin. Inner seed coat called stigma. This is the diagrammatic representation. Then the parts before fertilization in a flower are the sepals, petals, stamen, style and stigma. After fertilization, all these parts fall off. The ovary becomes the fruit. The ovule gets transformed into seed, egg. Upon fertilization becomes a zygote. Funicle becomes the stalk of the seed. Micropyle of the ovule. In case of a seed, the micropyle of the seed facilitates oxygen and water uptake. The nucellus become perisperm. Outer integument of the ovule becomes the outer seed coat. It is also known as testa. The inner integument is known as tegmen. The synergid cells which are present on either side of the egg degenerates. The secondary nucleus becomes an endosperm. The antipodal cells which are present towards the cellagyl region also degenerates. So summary, the events in sexual reproduction, that is pre-fertilization events, are gametogenesis and gamete transfer. The second one is fertilization, and the third one is post-fertilization events. The ovary becomes the fruit. Ovary wall becomes the fruit wall, which is known as pericarp. Ovule gets converted into seed. Outer integuments forms the outer seed coat, that is testa. Inner integument becomes inner seed coat, which is known as tegmen. The secondary nucleus becomes endosperm. Egg becomes zygote, synergids, and antipodals degenerates. Hilum, funicle, and micropyle shows no changes. Thank you.